Hello friends, so welcome to my video. In this video we'll be talking about asset allocation. So this is for everyone who's 20 years old, 30 years old, 40 years old. Asset allocation is very important. Why? Not because they generate maximize your return, but because they minimize the risk. So basically during COVID, March, in the month of March, if a person had 100% into equity, he would have lost his mind to see that like 7,000, like half of his money would have gone, and then again if he had waited he would have made it back. But that's not how human behavior is. Whenever we see something falling, we just give it off and we try to recover money. That's where asset allocation comes. It plays a vital role when it comes to minimize the risk. So asset allocation is one part wherein, like, how much percentage of what, that is, like, should you invest in gold, equity, international equity or debt. This is what asset allocation is. Then security allocation is specific in asset, like in equity, which, where should I invest in bonds, where should I invest. And then market timing is something that's left to your own discretion. Like, people say they can time market, but it's really not possible to time the market. So yeah, these are the three basic rules, and we'll be talking about everything in this series of mine. So watch this entire series if you are someone who's planning to make some good investment or savings for your retirement. There are components of asset allocation, that is Indian equity, there is international equity, gold and debt. So we'll start off by talking about gold, which is the smallest weightage should be given to your portfolio. And why it is necessary is here, because Nifty and gold has a correlation value of 0.01. That is, like, if Nifty goes down, gold goes up drastically. And if you have seen in March, it is enough, like, gold reached all time high price and Nifty fell to half of its value. So this shows that there is need for gold. That is, like, when Nifty goes down, you have something that is giving you a return higher than Nifty. So that's why whenever stock market goes down, gold goes up. So that should be one of the fundamental gold is, like, should be in your asset. And its weightage will tell you how much. So ways to invest in gold: there is physical gold, gold mutual fund, gold ETF and sovereign gold fund. Physical gold is something that is dearly to Indians, and I don't have to talk about this much, but these are the three things which are, like, relatively new concept to many Indians, so I'll be talking about that. First is gold ETF and gold mutual fund. So basically gold ETF is nothing but you are buying, like, stock, whereas gold mutual fund is nothing but you are investing in a mutual fund of equity. So for investing in stocks, that is gold ETF, you know you'll need demat account, whereas gold mutual fund there is no need, and minimum one stock needs to be bought, like, similarly minimum 1 gram, whereas here you can invest any small amount, sometimes even 100 rupees. And then taxation is same for both of them. I'll tell about taxation also. And returns are comparable for gold ETF and gold mutual funds. So charges are also, like, paid for stocks. You know, like, Zerodha, when you're selling, you'll have to pay some brokerage and then DP charges. So those are the charges when it comes to gold ETF, whereas gold mutual fund, you'll pay it as expense ratio. So it's just matter of convenience when it comes to gold ETF and gold mutual fund. Whereas there's one more which is called sovereign gold bonds. Sovereign gold bonds, these are issued by RBI at a price of gold during the issue. So every year RBI will decide the dates for which it is launching sovereign gold bonds, and 3 days before that they'll take mean average or something like that. They calculate and they decide the price for releasing the bond. So you can buy these bonds at the price, and what you get is you'll get 2.5% interest for holding that, and that is paid on the price which you pay for buying the bond. So now let's say 5,000 rupees you pay to buy the bond, so you'll get 2.5% of 5,000 every year, and this 2.5% is paid semi-annually. Okay, and main thing is it has lock-in period of 5 years, which you can redeem at the end of 5 years, or you can extend it up to 8 years also. Then at maturity, what happens is, like, after 5 years, they'll give you the price of gold at the maturity. So let's say when you bought it, gold price was 5,000 per gram. So you got one bond, 1 gram of one bond. And then when it's expiry, its price is 6,000. So you'll get 6,000 rupees at the maturity and an additional interest of 2.5% semi-annually. So if you want to redeem it before maturity, you can do that as well. So what you can do is, like, you can trade it in secondary market. But if you're trading it at secondary market, the disadvantage is that, so you are trading it in secondary market because people know in market that you are in need of money. That's why you want to trade it in secondary market, and that's because of reason which it's always traded at discount price in secondary market. So if you are planning to buy SGB, then it's better to do it from our secondary market. And if you are planning to sell it, then it's better to do it with the RBI. So if you are ready to hold it for 5 to 8 years, and only then think about sovereign gold bonds. So how to buy sovereign gold bond on secondary market is basically you go to Zerodha or any other platform that you trade with, then go and type SGB, and then you'll get a series. So if you're looking for something that's expiring on August 2028, then just type August 2028, you will get this. So why I have chosen this is because, like, August 2028, so it's 8 years maturity. So basically they have given out the bond on August 2020. So on during August 2020 was the highest price for gold. They issued like 5,300 rupees or something. So you are getting highest interest in this, and this is like the best bond you can buy right now because the issue price was very high. So your annual interest is also coming at a like good high annual interest you are getting. And then yeah, you will be selling it at price at which it's trail, like at which the maturity date, whatever the gold price is, you will be getting that much. So again, to see how, just go to Google, give on RBI prices for SGBs, you will get the list, and it shows what was the price for each tranche, that is like each bond they have released. So you can add 8 years to that date of issue, and then you can search for it in the secondary market, and whichever you find as a lucrative deal, you can buy it. So now if we compare of gold mutual fund, gold ETFs or in gold bonds, you saw minimum investment 500, whereas in these two both 1 gram again gold mutual fund. Then cash flow, there is no cash flow in ETF or mutual fund, there is cash flow in sovereign gold bonds. Cash flow is nothing but you get money from every year, your annual, semi-annually. Then timing, not important. So what do I mean by timing? I'll tell you. Next slide. So lock-in period, as you know, there is no lock-in period for these two. You can redeem it whenever you want, but you will have exit load if you redeem it within a year or something. That again depends on fund house. So see to it and only then invest. And these sovereign gold bonds, yes, 5 years minimum you have to hold it. So if you're investing in gold, please think of long term. I know you do this also with physical gold, like you buy it and keep it for 10, 20, 30 years. So that's how your view should be when it comes to buying digital gold also. And taxation, if we talk about taxation, for gold ETF and gold mutual fund, it's short-term capital gain tax if you redeem it within 3 years as per your income slab. So if you fall under 30%, then you'll be charged 30%, whereas long-term capital gain 20% with indexation benefit. So long-term, so if you want to understand what indexation benefit is, please let me know in comments. I'll make a video on that, just a 1 minute video is what I'll do. And interest is taxed as income tax, where in sovereign gold bond, so every year you get 2.5% interest, that is taxed as income tax, but the money which you'll get when you sell the bond is capital gain free of tax. So this is one of the most important point about SGBs, that is like they're capital gain tax free when you're selling it. So what I meant by timing was, if you see gold prices, if you see, this was 2008 subprime mortgage crisis, which was there here 2008, and that time gold price rallied up really, really well. And then if you see for almost 8 years, it has remained almost flat. In fact, it has gone down and then it has come up to its 8 years below before value. So imagine if you bought a sovereign gold bond here, then what would have happened? Nothing much, like your price would have same stayed here, you would have got like 2.5% annually. FD will do better than that. So that's why when it comes to timing, you'll have to, but imagine you had invested in mutual fund, you will keep investing, sip, you'll keep doing, and once you see that it has gone up, you'll redeem it. So that's how STBs are like what one disadvantageous position when compared to mutual funds and ETFs. So this is one more thing. And remember, gold price always goes up when there is an economic crisis. So now let's say, God forbid, like that, say there's a gold, World War III or something like that, or some other crisis or some other pandemic coming, then obviously gold price will go up because people will shift their assets from equity to gold, and that's how prices will go up. Now what is happening is people are coming back from gold to the equity, that's why its price is going down. So I would say this would not be a really good time to buy STP, like waiting for some more time, or anyway, it's difficult to time, so it's up to you, it's up to your decision. So yeah, I'll conclude this. I'll say what I would prefer to invest in. So now, before seeing what how in what to invest, let me tell you how much to invest. So as you know, gold, it returns very less return over a like long term. Only when there is crisis, they give phenomenal return. So allocating more than 10% is not at all suggested. So if you're young, then I would say invest only 5%, because like if there is a crash in market, then you have time for the your like you can give your investment time to grow back to its original value. So I would say only 5% in your portfolio and gold, and you can gradually increase it to 10% over the years. Like initially I would say 5%. Then so when to buy, as I said, look for it. Like it's difficult to time really. But yeah, it's up to you. So it's better to do a mutual fund SIP every month and keep accumulating it, and then once very high price you can just sell it. So what to buy, as I said, STB's timing is very important. If your bond expires at a time when gold price is not so phenomenal, then your portfolio is underperforming. So basically the amount which you have invested for 8 years lock in will give you just 2.5% annually. Whereas in gold ETF, timing is not a matter, because you will hold it like stock and you can redeem it whenever the market is up, gold prices go up. But minimum investment again here is 4,500, and here the timing of redeeming is not there, or the buying is not there, but again here timing of buying. So if you buy prices at very high price, then you have to hold it for longer time. Whereas when it comes to gold mutual fund, you just keep doing SIP every month. So you will keep buying when market is low, even when market is high. So your prices will be better than these people, because it's very difficult to time the market. So my suggestion would be to invest in mutual fund of gold and keep on investing it. So I would invest in gold mutual fund, but only disadvantage is taxation. But if you're someone who's very high net worth individual, then I would suggest you to invest in sovereign gold bonds because of its taxation benefit. Yeah, you can choose STBs in such a way that every month there is one expiring, every month there is one STB expiring, so that you don't lose out on return whenever there is high time. So that is one more thing which I'd like to conclude. So which mutual fund to invest in, I'll be sharing in my next series. So wait and watch. So my future videos, like I'll be sharing a complete mutual fund portfolio for all the debt classes and how to invest. So stay tuned, and yeah, thank you.